Hi, Kim from Kim's Upholstery here. In this short video made for beginners, we show you the steps involved in upholstering a wooden armchair. The chair that we've used in this video is a Queen Anne style armchair. We do have a longer, more detailed version available through our website at kimsupholstery.com. So we've got our chair all ready to start building it back up. So we've tied the springs, which is with burlap, and now we're ready to put on the edge roll and start putting on the padding. I've cut my edge roll to the size of my chair, and this is a 1-inch edge roll that I'll be using for this. I've torn off a piece of my synthetic cotton, and now I will lay it over the chair, and we'll just tear off the excess once I get it positioned. So now I'm just tearing off the excess around the back rails here. And this will end up tucking in behind. And now we'll probably add 3 or 4 more layers to this. Now here's layer number 5. And as you can see, I'm bringing it down further so that it'll cover the wood down here on the side. So I've cut my piece of dacron. It's a 1-inch dacron, which is what I use. It's a bonded dacron. And you'll notice with the bonded dacron, one side's a little bit rougher than the other, so I always put it soft side up. So we'll get that positioned on the chair and then make our cuts. We're all padded up, and now I've cut my fabric. So how I measured for my fabric was I went down to the wood all across the widest part. I added 2 inches to each side for pull, and I did the same thing front and back, making sure I add enough allowance to get underneath the back of the chair, because that's where the fabric will be stapled. I've picked the location for my main motif in the fabric, and I've also marked the center of my chair down underneath. So what I'm going to do is take the center of the fabric, match it to the center of the chair with it the distance that I want it front to back, and we'll get a staple in there. Now I'm going to also mark the center of my back area where the fabric's going to come so that I can make sure I keep that motif straight. So we've got our front attached, so now what I'm going to do is push my fabric towards the back, and I'm going to feel with my hands where these rails come down, and we're going to make a cut into that rail area. So I've got my center point marked here, and I know this red stripe is my center. So I'll line those up. Just get a couple staples. We're attached in the front, and we've got some temporary staples in the back. We know the fabric needs to pull down around the front and get stapled all the way around here. So what I'm doing is kind of pulling the fabric where it's going to land so that I can see what it does when it gets near the arm. And then we're going to find the center of the arm, and we'll mark our fabric. So we've got our cut started. Now I'm coming back to the front, and I'm marking where the leg meets the bottom of the chair. And I'm going to cut around there. So now we're stapled all along the top of the leg, and I've got a couple staples under here temporary. So what we need to do is have this fabric fold nice along the arm area. So I'm going to fold it back, just kind of pushing it into that area next to the padding, and we're going to cut, leaving just a little bit to fold under. Now we'll do the same exact thing we did on the other side. We're going to fold this up, mark where our cuts are, make our cuts, and pull it down. Now we're ready to start attaching the front edge. And then we'll start stapling that down. So this part here is going to go straight around the back of the leg to the back. Get a nice fold. That looks good. Get one in there. And then we'll fill the rest of this in. We'll make a cut up here along the leg and we'll be ready to start the other side. So we're on the other side. We just finished the first side. Gonna get a few staples to hold this one. And then we'll fill it in as we go. Now the seat's just about done. What we have to do is attach the back. So we got a staple in there earlier. So we'll spin it around. And we'll finish attaching this. Our seat's all set. So now we need to pad the inside back and then we'll do the fabric for that. And last will be the outside. Now we'll start layering on cotton. Well, that's 5 layers of cotton and now we'll start attaching it. And then we'll get a layer of Dacron. So I've cut my piece of Dacron, so now we'll lay it over the chair. Oops, keep it up there. Just there, go down, and we'll start attaching it. Just like we did with the cotton. I've cut out my back fabric, and now what I'm doing is just lining up the pattern to keep everything the way I want it. And then we'll start attaching it and making our cuts. So I know I've got myself anchored at the top, so I'm going to pull my fabric down top where I want it, tucking it in, and we're going to make a cut in here headed towards that same place that I showed you in the back earlier. Now I'm going to be making the arm cuts, so again I'm feeling with my fingers. I've made my cut. Now we're going to put it where it needs to be. I'm going to tuck the point in, fold the edges of this under so I don't have a raw edge there. Folding it right underneath the padding that we've got. Bring it around to the back side. And we'll get a staple there. Now we're going to add some more staples. So here you'll see the 2 points that my V are going to be, it's that, and then I'm coming straight out. So our inside back is all attached, and I'm going to trim some of this excess away, and then we'll staple down this bottom. Now we've turned our chair over on it, what I call its knees, and we're going to start doing the cording on the outside back. I'm trying to feel the edge of the wood with my fingers to keep the cording right along there. Now we're ready to put on a layer of muslin, and what this does is just kind of covers that void so you don't have your back fabric bouncing around. So I've cut my curvies down to the size I need it, plus a little extra just in case I mismeasured. And we're going to start attaching it, riding it right up against your cording. There, now we're ready for the fabric. I've got my piece of Dacron cut out for the chair, but it's a little bit big, but we'll get it started here. And anywhere that I'm hanging over here on the sides, I'll also trim it down. So I've cut my fabric out. What I want to do is watch the center points. I'm going to get a temporary staple at an angle right here. So I'm going to use some pins to secure my back in place while I chalk it. And now we're going to chalk. And what I'm going to do is feel the row of cording, which I know you can't see it, but I can feel it with my fingers. And that's where I'm going to draw my chalk line. I'll do this all the way around. Now I'm going to start cutting just to the outside of my chalk mark, about 1/2 inch. I'm using my regulator, And what I'm doing with it is tucking the fabric into the curvies. Before I hammer this last part down here, what I'm going to do is make a cut in the fabric so that it rides up along the leg. Now continuing in the other direction, tucking with the regulator. Continuing all the way down, hammering in a little bit further down, then we'll make that same cut around the leg. Now we're ready to attach the cording to the bottom of the chair. Now I'm going to join these two ends together. I've cut my piece of dust cover to cover the bottom of the chair with a little bit of overhang. And here you have our completed Queen Anne armchair.